Hi guys, today I'm going to be upgrading the headlights from halogens to LEDs on this 2017 Honda Accord, and it gets even better because I have both low and high beams from two different manufacturers, which I would review and test as part of this video. If you've asked the question, are LEDs better than halogens for headlights, or if you're looking for the best car LED plug and play upgrade, you could find this video helpful. I'll demonstrate the beam patterns and reach of these bulbs and also check for the following: ease of fitment, presence or absence of flickers, that's something you really don't want, interference with the radio system, and finally fan noise. Now let's get this. LEDs are generally better than halogen bulbs because, one, they use less energy. Halogens produce a lot of heat. In fact, most of their energy is produced as heat and not actually light. However, halogens are cheaper, even though over the past few years, the cost margin between the two has been narrowing owing to a lot of research and development into LED bulbs. Again, another disadvantage of LEDs is that because the parts that power the LED chips make use of similar frequencies to your radio, traditional LED bulbs are going to cause interference with your radio. They would also have the flickering issues, except if a driver is fitted, which both bulbs we have today have drivers fitted and come Canbus ready. In layman's terms, that simply means that it's properly tuned for your computer to recognize those bulbs and not begin to send out codes that it's not able to detect bulbs.
I had been in the market for LED upgrades and actually made an order from Amazon, but thanks to USPS, my order never arrived. It was at this point that I had these two companies reach out almost simultaneously asking if I would be interested in reviewing these headlight bulbs. Just for disclosure, I only received these as free samples. I didn't get anything else, just in case you're wondering. They sent me a bag of money for a very good review. Now that that's out of the way, the specs are largely similar across the two brands. Both use the same high quality LumiLEDS ZES chips. The main differences are that the color temperature of the Auxito is 6500 Kelvin, while that of the Autoone is 6000 Kelvin. The operating life of the Auxito is greater than 30,000 hours, for the Autoone is 50,000 hours. The ingress protection for the Auxito is IP65 rating, while for the Autoone is IP67. IP65 simply means that this is resistant against water jets from all angles spraying to the bulb. So maybe you're washing your car with a pressure wash or something like that. IP67 is able to stay submerged in about 3 feet of water for less than 30 minutes. Let's go ahead and unbox these. I'll start with the Auxito. So this is the low beam and manual in English and Chinese, and then the bulb itself. Those are the LED chips. You have the cooling fan here, as well as the driver, to minimize issues with flickering and interference with the radio. Same goes for this, nothing different. I'm moving over to the Autoone. Manual as well. Thank you card. So quite similar to the Auxito. Auxito has the fan on top. Autoone has the fan here. Similar size, but the Autoone is a bit smaller. These are the H11s. So now the 9005s of Autoone. O-rings, just in case. I'm guessing just in case maybe your housing is a bit different, you may need to put one of these, I'm guessing. So again, Autoone on the right, Auxito on the left. Different designs. The Autoone feels just a bit smaller. At this point, just to clearly demonstrate, this is the halogen low beam made by Osram, very good manufacturing company out of Germany. H11 bulb, which we have here. So this is Auxito's H11, this is Autoone's H11. And very important, what I really want to point out here is that there's a very long debate about whether you can use LEDs in reflector housing. My low beam is a projector housing, which you can definitely use LEDs with. It's with the reflector housing, that's where this debate has been. So you will notice that what the LED is trying to do is to exactly mirror the position of the filament
on the halogen with the position of the LED chips. That includes the height at which it's placed and all of that. The end effect being that it's going to reflect off of the reflector in the housing exactly the same way that your regular halogen would. And we're going to be testing the beam pattern as well, so we'll see how closely it looks to the halogen.
For installing the bulbs, there's practically no difference between installing these bulbs and changing out an OEM bulb. Remove the connector by depressing the tab, twist the old bulb and then pull it out. For the low beam, you're able to reach it from the top as well as from under the frame for this bulkhead.
Checking out fan noise.
Both fans are on and actually not audible,
except if you put your ear very close to the fans. Checking out the interference on the radio. This is on AM band. I'm not sure what station this is, but let's just listen in. No meaningful interference on the radio for either of these bulbs. That said, there are a couple of vehicle brands that are quite sensitive. Some Minis, some Dodge, some Fords, and both manufacturers agree that in such cars, if you do experience flickering or static on the radio, an external Canbus decoder is going to be needed. It just works with the driver in the LEDs itself to try and balance out those issues.
Now, to check the beam pattern on the halogen and compare with the Auxito and Autoone, what I've done here is to mark the area of cutoff of the halogen low beam, HLB. Similarly, I've also marked the focus area for the halogen high beams, HHB. Note that the focus of the left high beam seems to be abnormally off. This could be down to something going on in the bulb itself. Both the Autoone and the Auxito beam patterns were a replica of the stock bulbs. In fact, the abnormally high focus point of the left high beam came lower to lie similar to the height on the right. I think there must have been an issue with the halogen high beam on the left. There's no flickering at all for both brands, so that's good to know. Next, road testing. Here's a comparison between the halogen and the Autoone while I was road testing. We'll delve deeper. Here's the halogen low beam as a baseline, and then moving on to the Autoone low beam. You can see that it provides better illumination of the road, and you are able to see more of the right side of the road. Moving on to the halogen high beam, the road is definitely more illuminated compared to the low beam. You're able to better visualize the top of the median barrier to the left and see farther into the distance. To the Autoone high beam, it's definitely an improvement on its halogen counterpart. Better illumination on both sides of the road, as well as better reach into the distance. Comparing the halogens against the Auxito, just another look at the halogen low beam baseline to refresh our memory before zeroing in on the Auxito low beams. The road is better illuminated, especially on the right hand side. Another look at the halogen high beam and then to the Auxito high beam. Again, better illumination on the right side of the road. The oncoming vehicle on the left has limited evaluation of the beam on that side. Reach appears to be either better or similar. Let me know what you think in the comments. Obviously, some of these observations are not scientific. They are my observations, but I welcome what you think in the comments. Also, I'll leave links in the description to both of these products. For the Auxito, there's a special discount code for 15% off. Any of these bulbs would be an improvement on halogens. You just have to love the look of the white light. One other thing, if you're considering getting an LED bulb, is to be sure of the specification for your car. Could be a H11, H7, and so on and so forth. That's it, guys. Like, share, comment, and subscribe if you've loved this. Catch you on the next one. Cheers.